symbols and notations. Let f be a real valued function defined on the closed interval a comma b. Throughout our discussion, capital M and small m respectively denote the supremum and the infimum of a bounded function f defined on the closed interval a comma b, and capital MR and small MR be the supremum and the infimum of F in the rth sub interval, namely closed interval XR minus 1 comma XR of the interval A comma B. Partition of the closed interval A comma B by a partition or dissection or a net of the closed interval a comma b, we mean a finite set of real numbers p is equals to the set consisting of x0 comma x1 comma x2 so on xr so on xn, where x0 is taken as a and the last point xn is taken as b in the closed interval a comma b, such that x0 is less than x1, less than x2, so on, less than xr, so on, less than xn. Partition of the closed interval a comma b is a finite ordered set. P is equals to the set x0 comma x1 comma x2, so on, xr, so on, xn is equals to b. The partition P of the closed interval a comma b consisting of n plus 1 points x0, x1, x2, so on, xr, so on, xn are called partition points of P. The n sub intervals closed interval x0 comma x1 comma closed interval x1 comma x2 comma closed interval xr minus 1 comma xr so on, the closed interval xn minus 1 comma xn are the intervals of partition and are called the segments of the partition P. By changing the set of points, the partition can be changed. Thus, there can be infinite number of partitions of the interval a comma b. The family of all partitions of the closed interval a comma b shall be denoted by script p of the closed interval a comma b, or the collection of all partitions of the closed interval a comma b is denoted by script p of the closed interval a comma b. If P belongs to script P of the closed interval a comma b, then P is one of the partitions of the closed interval. Capital IR stands for the rth sub interval xr minus 1 comma xr, and delta R stands for the length of the rth sub interval, that is delta R is equals to XR minus 1. We can also use this symbol delta. That is, delta R is the difference between last endpoint, first endpoint. That is, delta R equal to XR minus 1. Suppose the fifth subinterval, the closed interval X4 comma X5, then delta phi will be x5 minus x4. This is how we find the delta R, namely length of the rth sub interval. Now we'll define what is refinement of partition. If P1 and P2 are any two partitions of the closed interval a comma b, that is P1 comma P2 belongs to the script P of A comma B, such that P1 is a subset of P2. That that is P2 is the superset of P1, then P2 is called a refinement of P1, or P2 is finer than P1, and P1 is called coarser. Example, if P1 is equals to the set containing two points A comma B, P2 contains elements A comma C comma B, then clearly P1 and P2 are elements of the partition of A comma B. Also, P1 is a subset of P2 because P1 consists of two elements, namely A and B. P2 consists of three elements A, B and C. That is, P2 consists of one element more than P1. That is, every element of P1 is in P2. Therefore, P1 is a subset of P2, and hence P2 is finer than P1. If P2 is finer than P1, then every point of P1 is a point of P2. Yes, just now we discussed, every point of P1 is a point of P2, and P2 has some more points. Yes, P2 has one extra point, namely C, than P1. If P3 equals to P1 union P2, that is, union of two partition gives another partition, namely P3, then P3 is called a common refinement of the given two partitions P1 and P2, because P3 consists of all the elements of P1 and all the elements of P2. Therefore, P3 is called the common refinement of the two given partitions P1 and P2. Now we define what is norm of the partition or mesh. The maximum of the lengths of subintervals of a partition P is called the norm or mesh of the partition P, and is denoted by norm P. This symbol is called norm. This symbol is known as norm, or delta of P, or mu of P. That is, norm P is equals to maximum of XR minus 1, where R is running from 1 to N. We know that the closed interval A comma B consists of N subintervals. That is, X0 comma X1, X1 comma X2, so on. So we have to find the delta R, the length of the each subinterval. Which subinterval gives the maximum value, that is called norm P. For example, if P1 consists of two elements, namely A comma B, norm P is, we know that the difference of the two points, B minus A. P2 consists of three elements, A, C, B. Therefore, this will be having two subintervals, namely AC and CB. Both P1 and P2 are partitions of the closed interval A comma B. Then norm P2 will be either C minus A or B minus C. Either C minus A. The first subinterval is AC. See here, this is the first subinterval. This is the second subinterval. Therefore, the norm will be either C minus A or B minus A. Suppose C is very close to A, then B minus C gives maximum value. Suppose C is very close to B, then C minus A gives the maximum value. So this is represented by these two pictures. That is, if P2 is the set containing A comma C comma B, then there are two possibilities. The position of C may be close to A or close to B. If it is close to A, then B minus C is the maximum value. If it is close to B, then C minus A is the maximum value. Therefore, norm P is less than B minus A. Because what is B minus A? The whole length is B minus A, here to here. That will be more than C minus B or B minus C. Therefore, norm P is less than norm P1, where P1 is subset of P2. So this point is very clear that if P1 is a subset of P2, then norm P2 will be less than norm of P1. P2 has more number of points than P1. But when you come to the norm, P1, norm of P1 is more than norm of P2. That is, if P1 and P2 are two partitions of the closed interval A comma B, and P1 is contained in P2, then norm P2 is less than norm P1. The next result is important result. Sum of delta R running from 1 to N, namely put R equal to 1, delta 1 plus the symbol sigma is there, therefore we have plus. Now put R equal to 2, we have delta 2 plus, so on, R is equal to N, that is plus delta N. Since we have N sub intervals, delta 1 stands for length of the first sub interval, delta 2 stands for length of the second sub interval, delta N stands for length of the last sub interval. We know that delta 1 is the length of the sub interval, namely closed interval x0, which is equal to a comma x1. Therefore, delta 1 will be x1 minus a. These are the n sub intervals of the partition p of a comma b, namely x0 comma x1, where x0 is a, the closed interval x1 comma x2, the rth sub interval is closed interval xr minus 1 comma xr, the nth sub interval is closed interval x minus 1 comma xn equals to b. What is delta 1 here? Delta 1 is x1 minus x0, that is x1 minus x0 is a, so x1 minus a. What is delta 2? X2 minus x1. What is delta 3? X3 minus x2. What is delta r? XR minus 1. What is delta N? XN minus XN minus 1. That's what you written here. Delta 1 is X1 minus A. Delta 2 is X2 minus X1. Delta N is XN, that is B minus XN minus 1. If you add all these sum, X1 minus X1 get cancelled, X2 minus X2 get cancelled. Similarly, xn minus 1 also get cancelled. So all the terms get cancelled in pairs except minus a plus b, that is b minus a. And hence, sum of delta r is running from 1 to n, is nothing but B minus A, that is difference of the closed interval A comma B. Now we define what is upper dot box sum and lower dot box sum. The dot box sum is also known as Riemann sum. Let F be a function from the closed interval A comma B to R be a bounded function, and P be a partition of the closed interval A comma B, let capital MR and small MR be the supremum and the infimum of the function F in the rth sub interval, namely closed interval XR minus 1 comma XR, where R is running from 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, N, then the sum r equal to 1 to n capital MR into delta R, that is equals to, put R equal to 1, we get M1 delta 1. This is the one, capital M1 delta 1. Summation symbol is there, therefore plus. Put R equal to 2, then we get capital M2 into capital delta 2. Capital delta 2. Then summation symbol, therefore we have a plus. Now keep R equal to 3, then we have capital M3 into delta 3, so on. Keep R equal to N. The last one is capital Mn into delta N. This is denoted by U of P comma F. This is known as, that is U of P comma F is equal to sum capital MR delta R, where R equal to 1 TN is known as upper dot box sum or upper Riemann sum. Similarly, we can define the lower Riemann sum or the lower dot box sum, namely summation R equal to 1 to N small MR into delta R. That is equals to, when you expand this, keep R equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, we get M1 delta 1 plus M2 delta 2 plus so on Mn delta N. That is equals to capital L of P comma F. This L of P comma F is equals to sum R equal to 1 to N MR, small MR into delta R is known as lower dot box sum or lower Riemann sum. These are called upper and lower dot box sums or Riemann sums with respect to the partition P of A comma B. For different partition of the closed interval A comma B, we get different upper dot box sums and different lower dot box sums. Now, using this definition of upper Riemann sum and lower Riemann sum, we will solve some problems.